Hi, this is Dr. Steven Eisen, and this is my dog, Angel. And she's barking up the wrong tree. Chances are you're watching this right now because your dog has cancer. If that's the case, I'm really sorry. I know how devastating that can be. You see, a couple of years ago I went through that with my dog, Fergie, who had the worst type of cancer a dog can get. And chances are the advice you've gotten about your dog's cancer has you barking up the wrong tree as well. I've developed a unique protocol that cured Fergie of her cancer, and it may help you with your dog too. Fergie lived to reach her full normal life expectancy. More about that in a minute. But first, there are a couple of important things I think you should know. According to the ASPCA, about 60% of all dogs over the age of 6 will be diagnosed with some type of cancer. That's an epidemic. If this was happening to people, it would be an emergency of the highest priority. But why is this happening to our pets? Well, when you first got your dog, you took him to the vet and wanted to do everything you could to keep him healthy. So your vet probably told you to get your dog vaccinated every year and perhaps put them on a diet of special dog food that maybe they sold in their office, and probably told you to get some other stuff, things like spot-on flea and tick treatments that they probably sold in their office as well. And like most dog owners, you trusted your vet. It's not your fault you didn't know that almost everything your vet told you if you really wanted to keep your dog healthy was wrong. Unfortunately, most dog owners have been following dangerously mistaken advice from their vet. Did your vet tell you that all those vaccinations don't actually prevent many of the diseases they claim to, but do cause all kinds of health problems in dogs, including cancer? Or did they tell you that regular vaccinations severely impair your dog's immune system, which needs to be strong to prevent diseases like cancer? Or did they tell you that mostly all commercial dog food, including the kind they sell in their office, contains high amounts of harmful bacteria, human drugs like penicillin and phenobarbital, mold and fungus, pesticides and fertilizers, and many other compounds that cause cancer? Oh, and did your vet tell you that that spot-on flea and tick treatment contains the toxic chemicals that are in bug sprays, and that's why there are over 40,000 complaints to the FDA every year about these products causing death and seizures in pets? Would you put that on your child? So now that your dog has cancer, do you really think that the recommendations are going to get better? Well, think again. Only 1 in 5 dogs who undergo conventional treatments like chemotherapy and radiation is still alive after 2 years of that type of treatment. Hopefully, it's not too late to do some things that can get your dog healthy again. Please watch this for a few seconds and see if this dog looks sick to you. This is a video of Fergie, and it was taken more than a year after the vet told me that she only had about 6 weeks to live from one of the most aggressive and devastating types of dog cancer there is, lymphoma. Fergie lived for an astounding 29 more months after her death sentence. That's 2 years and 5 months. Any doctor who understands the devastating consequences of this disease and diagnosis understands how utterly amazing this is. Many people who know this story asked me if I could share the unique holistic protocol I used with Fergie that produced this amazing outcome. To do that, I wrote a step-by-step guide so that anyone could do this with their dog, no matter what type of cancer they have. The result is my book, Dog Cancer, The Holistic Answer, and it's designed so that anyone can follow the protocol simply to heal their dog with cancer. It's designed to reverse the damage caused by the toxins in vaccinations, dog food, and pesticides, and it explains the protocol I use to restore Fergie to vibrant health. It's not a magic bullet approach, but rather a synergistic combination of diet and supplements that accounts for factors that may be different for individual dogs. This life-saving resource is now available to you to help you and your dog, and you can find out more about it at dogcanceradvice.com. I hope to see you there. Thank you.